Yeah, I don't know if you can hear me because I didn't levels this quite well, but no, I'm just following something like a couple of different images, and I'm doing all right. Just trying to relax after a long day. I'm kind of eyeballing this, like these different images, and just trying to make something. Me too. I'm gonna try to do just like a clay render, I think, rather than, well, I might do some like skin or something, but I think this stage is actually the most fun because it's just so basic and you're just trying to find something like a cool design. Oh, I'm glad you like the work. Thanks, man. I appreciate it. Gonna merge these together. Make the commitment. Boink. Smiley dragon, like that. I'll go with that. Someday I'll finish the Balrog I started. Huh. I should save this. Always forget to save, and then kaboom. It crashes. Do you think it's worth becoming an artist in the games industry? Competition so I hardly any junior positions where I can tell. I mean, I think so. I think it is getting more competitive, and yeah, when I like first started, it was, I mean, yeah, it's such a hard thing to answer, but I think if you enjoy doing stuff, then I think it's really just like, 'cause for me, like when I was like a graphic designer back in the day, and I didn't know any 3D. I just love games, and then my interest in just loving games got me into sculpting, and so I kind of went down the road of doing all these different jobs, and just by chance getting into games. But I think depends really where you want to attack the industry. If you want to be like characterized, it is quite challenging. But you can do it, and I think if you love games, it'll come through, and like the reason why I still do stuff now is because I just enjoy doing it, not for any purpose really, not to get a job or anything. And I think people see that. They'll see that you love it, and you just want to like do stuff, and then hopefully a job lines up with what you're doing and what you're interested in. But it's still definitely worth it. I think if you'd really love it, you'll eventually break through. But it is difficult. It just takes a bit more, I guess, a bit more commitment now because the competition's so high. But I think if you really love it and you go for it, you can do it. But I kind of fell into it, if I'm honest. Because I used to do graphic design and like fine art, like oil painting. But I still love games. Like playing games and stuff. explain your thought process when tackling this thing. Yeah, I mean, I think for me, like, the easiest way is thinking about obviously like the big shapes. So like when I had it earlier, I had just like this big cylinder, and I was mapping out like, you know, all these like huge quadrants. I think the easiest way is doing it with like those big primitives. But then when you get like something like this, where you're starting to imply some skin, it's just trying to think of those primary forms, but not like moving too far away. So like when you, so like we have this big shape here, and we want to kind of start putting some creases. I'm still kind of, I'm not going too far away from the silhouette. I'm kind of still staying in the silhouette. So it's kind of like you block in the primary, and then when you do the secondary, it doesn't kind of go away too far. Because if you start going too far away from the primary, it kind of breaks the whole surface of the skin. So right now, when I do the secondary stuff, I'm just being very light with it and thinking about tension. So implying something and then just smoothing it. It's so like here, it's getting like super bumpy. So I'll use the clay brush to kind of even it all out. Rather than just smooth it. And then either with the standard or the damp standard, just thinking about surface tension. And then smoothing it out. But staying within the primary, I'm still quite close to that primary form. Because when you're mapping the primary forms, you want to just be thinking about big shapes. And then as you get smaller to secondary, tertiary, you kind of get you staying within the constraints of the primary. And then some of the other stuff is just kind of observation. So trying to like look at something, try to imply it. But keeping everything smooth, I think is kind of like, you don't want to just blitz stuff with detail too soon. You want to kind of build up to it slowly. I hope that helps. man. Hope you're good. I'm just wrapping up, and I think I'll continue this another day. Because there's so much detail and needs to be done. I'm just trying to get some kind of render.